Good morning, children. Welcome to English class. Children, in today's session, we are going to discuss lesson 12, La Chala, the top, part 2. So, this lesson is the continuation of 11th lesson, La Chala, the top, part 1. Now, this is part 2. So, La Chala is the special top which belongs to a little girl called Ria. La Chala flash red and yellow lights, which is so wonderful. Ria used to spin La Chala for the whole day, and even La Chala loves to spin round and round and even fly in the air. La Chala likes it very much. One day, Ria, before going to bed, she put La Chala on the table and she went to the bed. That La Chala doesn't like to sit idle, so it slowly rolled down and went out of the bedroom of Ria. La Chala hopped down slowly, jumped down from the table and quietly rolled out of the door. And then La Chala began to spin round and round and fly in the air. La Chala was flying in the air and saying that, "Watch me dance in the air." By seeing La Chala, mosquitoes were discussing that, who's that? Then Granny Mosquito said that it's not a mosquito, not Sibi, then what is it? And the Teeny Mosquito said it must be a flying saucer, and see the lights, red and yellow lights are very beautiful. Granny Mosquito buzzed, "Flying saucer, so fly away from here to save your lives." By seeing that, La Chala laughed at the mosquito. "Silly fellows," it thought and laughed. Then dropped down itself and rolled into the living room. In the living room, all the tables and chairs were very quiet and still. They were not moving. So the room was very quiet. Then La Chala, it sang that, "Want to watch me dance?" By listening to the sound, Grandpa Sofa opened his eyes and said that, "Who is that making noise?" Then Big Chair replied that shining little thing. And Big Table said that, "It's just a top." Listening to the words of the Big Table, La Chala cried out that, "I'm not just a top, I'm a dancing top." Then Big Table replied, "Tops doesn't dance, they don't dance, just they will spin." But La Chala said, "Oh yes, they do, but you can't move your leg also." So Big Table yield that, "I can move." Now La Chala landed on the smooth surface of the Big Table and started skating. So Big Table shouted that, "Get down, it hurts me." La Chala slid off the table. Then Big Table yield that, "Catch her." La Chala sang that, "You can't catch me," and flew away through the window. Now the small table said to Big Table that she has ran away through the window, and Big Table shouted that, "Catch her quickly." Now the Big Chair opened the door, the Big Table came out, and the Big Chair followed the Big Table. Now the remaining small chairs, small tables, all they have followed the Big Table, and all they went out of the door except the Grandpa Sofa and the dining table. So La Chala was humming in the streets and going on, flying in the air, telling that, "Catch me if you can." So that is about part 1. Now in part 2, what happened? Let us discuss. Now they have opened the doors of the house and La Chala went out, followed by the Big Table, small table, big chairs and small chairs. All they went out. Then what happened? We'll see. Yeah. Bugloo was looking for a house to rob. The tables and chairs had left the door open. Bugloo saw that. "Wonderful," he said, and slipped inside. The tables and chairs chased La Chala. "Catch me if you can," hummed La Chala. She spun around the Big Table. She bounced on the big chair. She twinkled the small table. She made circles around the dining chair's legs. So here, Bugloo was the thief. He was looking out to rob the house at night. Now what happened here as the chairs and tables have left the door open, Baglu saw that the doors of the house was open. So he went into that. He thought that wonderful. And then it's wonderful that I got a house where the doors are open. It is very easy for him to theft the things. Here, the chairs and tables were chasing Latula, and Baglu, the thief, went into the house. And Latula was singing, humming that, catch me if you can. And then Latula has spun around the big table, bounced on this big chair, and she started twiddling the small table. Like that, it is irritating all the big table, big chair, small table, small chairs. And she made circles around the dining chair legs. So like that, she is disturbing all the chairs and the tables. Catch that top, yield the big table. The dining chairs tried, the big chair tried, the small chair tried. But Latla jipped around so fast that they all fell into a heap. Now, the big table shouted that, catch that top. As Latla is singing the song, disturbing them. Spun around the big table, bounce around the big chair, twinkle the small table, and even spinning around the dining chair's legs. So big table shouted, catch the top. So the dining chairs tried to catch Latula, but they failed. The big chair tried, but it was also failed. The small table tried and failed. So Latula has started jipped around them all so fast that all the chairs and tables fell down and form a heap. Then Latula decided to rest for a while. The mosquito family were flying around too. They saw Latula resting on the ground. The flying saucer teeny mosquito shivered. Now even the mosquitoes has came out of the house. Now Latula was very much tired of bouncing, jumping, running, flying. So Latula thought to take rest for a while. Then the mosquitoes family saw Latula and they were flying around Latula. So Latula was taking rest on the ground and teeny mosquito shivered that flying saucer. The flying saucer is very dangerous. Then, let's check, said Granny Mosquito. It's just a top, she cried. Wait, we'll teach you to chase us out, the mosquito shouted. Time to go home, Latula sang. She flew off. The mosquitoes followed. Now, teeny mosquito shouted that, the flying saucer. Then Granny Mosquito, it said, let's check. Now she cried out that it's not a mosquito, it's not a bee, it's just a top. Then the mosquito shouted on Latula that, wait, we'll teach you a lesson, we'll teach you to chase us out. Now Latula, it took rest for a while, then opened its eyes and it sang that, now it's time to go home. So she started going back to home. She flew in the air and even the mosquitoes also followed Latula. Baglu was busy filling his bag with stolen things. Latula flew bang into his face. The mosquitoes flew zoom into his face. The tables and chairs went slam into Baglu. Baglu fell flat on the floor. The mosquitoes began to sting him. The tables and chairs fell on top of him. Yield Baglu. Rhea woke up. Her mother and father woke up. Now here, as Latula thought that it's time to go back to home, it flew in the air and even mosquitoes also followed Latula. Now Baglu was very much busy filling his bag with all the stolen things. So suddenly Latula flew and it hit the face of Baglu. So then the mosquitoes also flew, making sound, zoom, zoom sound, and hit the face of Baglu. And even the chairs and tables also hit Baglu. So Baglu fell down as Latula hit him on the face. Mosquitoes also flew onto him, and tables and chairs all they fall on him. So Baglu fell on the floor. Now the mosquitoes began to bite him. So began to sting him. Even the chairs and tables, everything was fallen on him. So with lots of pain, he had started out crying, yielding out that, ee, yeah, yeah. So By listening that sound, Ria woke up. Even father and mother of Ria also woke up. Ria, father and mother, all they woke. Then what happened? Now we'll see. What's happening? They cried. Lachla quickly rolled under Ria's bed. Ria and her mother and father came running out. Who are you? They asked Baglu. What are you doing here? Now, Ria's parents and Ria, everyone has started crying out that what's happening. Then Lachla quickly rolled down the Ria's bed. Ria's father and mother and Ria, all they came out running. Then they saw Baglu in the hall. So they asked Baglu that, who are you and what are you doing here in our house? So Ria, father and mother, all they came to the living room and they asked Baglu that, who are you and what are you doing? Now Baglu tried to open his mouth. He said, "Urr." He tried to get up, but the tables and chairs were too heavy. Lachla saw his bag. She rolled out and spun around his bag. He's got a bag, Ria cried. What's in that bag? Now the parent, father, mother, Ria, all they have shouted at Baglu that, who are you? What are you doing here? Then Baglu said, "Rrr." He tried to get up, but all the tables and chairs are there on him and they were too heavy. So he was unable to get up. Then Lachla saw his bag. She rolled out and spun around his bag. So now Lachla saw the bag of the thief. Now you can see here in the picture, the thief and all the chairs, Lachla, everything has fallen on the thief. Now Lachla saw the bag. There is a bag. Baglu has filled his bag with all the things. So it rolled out and spun around the bag. By seeing that, Ria cried out that he's got a bag. What's in that bag? Now Ria identified that Lachla is spinning around the bag. So she cried out that he had a bag and what's there in the bag. Baglu tried to grab his bag and run. Thief, cried Ria, catch him. Lachla whirled under his feet. Baglu fell down and was caught. My smart little top, cried Ria. Lachla danced a happy little dance. Now as Lachla was spinning around the bag, Ria shouted that he got a bag and what's there in the bag. So Baglu tried to grab that bag and run away from there. And Ria cried, thief, thief, catch him. So Lachla has spun around him. It's been around his feet. With that, Baglu fell down and he was caught by Ria's parent. Now Ria said to Lachla that, my smart little top. And Lachla danced with a lot of happiness, that a happy little dance. So that is about the lesson, Lachla the Top, part 2. This beautiful story was written by Deepa Agarwal. Deepa Agarwal has written the lesson, Lachla the Top. Hope you all have understood the lesson, children. Now with this, we'll close today's session. Coming to today's your homework, read lesson 12, Lachla the Top, part 2. Okay, children, that's it for today. See you in the next session. Bye, children.